Welcome to This Week in the Index. I'm your host, Grayson Brulte. Overall, it was the third down week in a row in the markets. For the week of August 14th, the Road to Autonomy Index declined 2.41%. The S&P 500 declined 2.06%. The NASDAQ 100 declined 2.36%. The Road to Autonomy Index underperformed the S&P 500 by 0.35%. The Road to Autonomy Index underperformed the NASDAQ 100 by 0.05%. The top performing stocks in the Road to Autonomy Index this week were NVIDIA, which returned 5.98%. MunichRe, which returned 3.08%. Uber, which returned 2.24%. While these stocks perform well, they are just three of the 38 publicly traded companies that are components of the Road to Autonomy Index. News and opinion drives the market, and this week in autonomy, there were some developments. On Friday, August 18, Deere Company, a Road to Autonomy Index component company, announced their Q3 2023 earnings. The earnings were strong as Deere reported worldwide net sales and revenues that increased 12% to $15.81 billion for the third quarter of 2023. Overall, year-to-date revenue increased 24% to $45.8 billion for the 9 months of 2023. Net income for the third quarter was $2.978 billion, compared with net income of $1.884 billion from the previous quarter. On the earnings call, Brent Norwood, Director of Investor Relations, Deere, addressed autonomy and said the following, end quote, "You're going to see more of that as our customers, particularly in like high-value crop production systems, they're demanding solutions like autonomy and electrification. And so that's going to be an opportunity to, I think, further buttress the margin profile that we've achieved this year and extend that into years to come," end quote. Deere's operating margin in Q3 2023 was 26.2%, up from 21.2% in Q2 2022. As Deere scales the autonomous 8R tractor and introduces more products that are autonomous, margins are going to continue to increase in the coming years for Deere. Could Deere introduce an autonomous tillage tractor as a service? After all, that's a possibility because of the bear flag with Deere acquired in August 2021 for $250 million. That was their business model. The future of Deere is autonomous. Today they say nothing runs like a Deere. Tomorrow they will say nothing runs like an autonomous Deere. Autonomy is going to be a big business in the future, and Deere is poised to capture significant market share as the company introduces new autonomous tractors and services. In San Francisco, autonomous vehicles are becoming a tourist attraction, attracting visitors to the city just to ride in an autonomous vehicle. As Miles Krupra, a reporter for the Wall Street Journal, pointed out in the Wall Street Journal's Tech News Briefing podcast, what it's like inside one of San Francisco's self-driving taxis, an episode that aired on August 18th, he was right. It is tourists. What autonomous vehicles are doing with San Francisco are injecting a much-needed economic stimulus in the city's economy. San Francisco's economy very much needs the economic stimulus of the city's in disarray, with rising crime and drug crisis that's gripping the streets of San Francisco. The crime and drug epidemic is so bad now, Governor Gavin Newsom is now deploying the California Highway Patrol and the state's National Guard to the city for multi-agency operating targeting fentanyl trafficking. The problem is real, and Governor Newsom recognizes this as he looks to potentially run for President of the United States. Despite his potential motives, Governor Newsom is doing the right thing. San Francisco is a beautiful city, but unfortunately, it's overrun with crime and drugs, and it's dirty. It's not somewhere you would want to visit today with your family for a vacation. Riding on one of the city's famous trolley cars or in an autonomous vehicle, it's going to have to wait for now. Tourists, they're following my lead. Tourists are not traveling to the city in the numbers they're used to pre-pandemic. San Francisco hotel occupancy is down from an average of 85% pre-pandemic to an average 65% today. This is a 20% drop in the occupancy rate, equaling millions of dollars in lost revenue for hotels. Tax revenue and overall spending in the city and surrounding areas. Then there are the passengers who board planes from SFO, San Francisco International Airport. Pre-pandemic in July 2019, 4.1 million passengers boarded domestic flights from SFO and 1.4 million passengers boarded international flights, compared to July 2023, when 3 million passengers boarded domestic flights from SFO and 1.1 million passengers boarded international flights. This is a decrease of 1.1 million passengers boarding domestic flights and 300,000 passengers boarding international flights. International boardings are recovering faster, while domestic boardings have not yet returned to pre-pandemic normals. Could this be a sign that domestic flights or business travel have not fully rebounded, or that the U.S. tourists are simply choosing to avoid San Francisco? Both are possible. What we do know is that the current makeup of the city is having a negative impact on the city's tourism economy, as visitors clearly have not returned. San Francisco needs to get clean, and when it does, tourists will once again return. This time they will not travel for the city's famous trolley cars, Fisherman's Wharf, or Lombard Street. They will travel to ride in an autonomous vehicle. Autonomous vehicles will become an economic tourism magnet for the city of San Francisco if the city changes for the better. However, time is running out as autonomous vehicles are scaling across the country. On August 15, 2023, Cruise announced they're expanding to Charlotte, North Carolina. Cities such as Charlotte, North Carolina, Nashville, Tennessee, Austin, Texas, and Miami, Florida will soon feel the economic impact of autonomous vehicles. Tourists will flock there instead of San Francisco because the cities are safer. While individuals around the United States wait for the opportunity to ride in an autonomous vehicle, investors are busy preparing for a round of IPOs this fall as the IPO market begins to thaw. The big IPO that investors are watching this fall is Arm. Arm is a licensing company that touches every aspect of mobility and computers. The iPhone is Arm. To date, Arm customers have shipped more than 250 billion devices running on Arm architecture. In Q3 2022, reported on February 7, 2023, Arm partners shipped a record 8 billion Arm-based chips. Adjusted EBITDA was 450 million. The adjusted EBITDA margin exceeded 50%. Licensing revenue was 300 million, up 65% year over year. Royalty revenue was 446 million, up 12% year over year. In SoftBank's latest financial results that were reported on August 8th, the company indicated a $45 billion fair assessment value for Arm at the end of June, up 13% from the previous quarter. On Friday, August 18th, SoftBank bought the remaining 25% of Arm that it did not already own at a $64 billion valuation from the Vision Fund. The Financial Times reporting that the amount of the transaction was valued at $16 billion, roughly double the price that the Vision Fund paid when it took the stake in 2017. On Monday, the initial paperwork for the Arm listing on NASDAQ in New York is expected to be made public. According to Reuters, Arm has been negotiating with 10 companies, including Intel, Alphabet, Apple, Samsung, and Amazon, to be anchor investors in the IPO. As part of the IPO, Arm is aiming to raise between $8 billion and $10 billion. Could the Arm IPO be the bellwether for what is to come in the IPO markets? Or will this be a one-off IPO? The Instacart IPO is lurking in the shadows. Whether Instacart goes public this year or next, that's yet to be determined. What we do know is that the IPO market is thawing. Looking to 2024, Seth Rubin, head of U.S. equity capital markets at Stifel, sees the IPO market accelerating in 2024. As markets thaw, we'll want to keep our eyes out on the data and what happens with inflation and consumer spending. It's been reported that Tesla has received over 1,102 Cybertruck reservations daily over the past 2 years, with the total reservation number currently standing at 1,313,851. With the average auto loan interest rates across all credit profiles ranging from 5.18% to 14.08%, we'll want to watch and see how many of these Tesla Cybertruck reservations actually close. When individual investors first started reserving the truck, interest rates were not as high as they are today, nor will they be as high as they are today in the future. The future for autonomy is bright as the IPO market begins to thaw and investors continue to invest in autonomy, as we saw at the JP Morgan 2023 Autos Conference. Autonomy is good for the economy. Autonomy is coming. Autonomous vehicles and autonomous trucks will help to usher in the autonomy economy. Today, we are merely at the starting line for what is to come with autonomy and its economic impact. In the future, autonomy will be one of the world's largest industries in the world. Autonomy is a business, and there is an index to track its performance. The autonomy economy is coming. Follow the Road to Autonomy Index, ticker Autonomy, on your favorite finance app. Again, the ticker is Autonomy, AUTONOMY. Be sure to join us again next Sunday for the latest installment of the Road to Autonomy's This Week in the Index. The future is bright, the future's autonomous, the future is an Arm IPO and a thawing IPO market.